Hi, in this lesson, we are going to learn how to use templates in a storybook. So right now, we only have three different stories. And let's focus on the first one, the default. What if I want to write more stories? For instance, let's write two more and let's call the second one clickable because this is going to be a car that we can click. And let's call this one draggable. I will have to write here is draggable. This is going to be a Boolean prop and is clickable. But what about if this is a very repetitive process and I have to do this multiple times with multiple props? Right now it's pretty simple because it's just one prop. But if I have some kind of base props that I want to replicate, this is going to be a very repetitive task. So there is this concept in Storybook, and this is the new way to use a Storybook when you create a new const called template. And basically this template is going to receive some args. And what is going to do this function is going to render our component with the spread of those args. Then if I really want to write the different stories, what I can do is just say that the story and look at this is not going to be a function. This is going to be the template itself, and I'm going to bind it to an empty object. This is with the end of not going to override their context. So what I can do right now, I can define that all of these, the clickable is a template, and the same from the draggable is going to be a template. And in order to change the props, what I'm going to use is the story, and I'm going to define the new args. In this case, I can say is clickable is going to be true. I can copy and paste this one for draggable. In this case, draggable is going to be draggable and it's going to be true. Right now, this looks pretty simple because we don't have that many props, but this is going to be very useful because if you have a lot of defaults props here, you don't need it to replicate. You just change whatever you want to change. And of course, we have these two new stories, and I can start Storybook to start seeing the changes. But how does it look? Of course, we don't really have anything with, so let's just update that. So now I'm going to receive is clickable and is draggable, right? I'm going to put two different classes for is clickable only when is clickable is true. For is draggable only when is draggable is true. So I'm going to write is draggable only when draggable is true. You can notice there is some kind of complaint here. Oh, this is because I'm missing the comma here. We should write some prototypes because right now I don't see this in my table. So I should write some prototypes for those props. So in this case, is clickable is going to be prototypes and it's going to be Boolean object. And then for is draggable is going to be the same. As soon as I put this here, I should be able to see the props here. And let's just add styles because of course right now I have the stories. I have the story is clickable, is draggable, but there is no any difference as you can notice. If we go to the CSS and let's write these two new classes, that's why I really like this approach because then you can maintain this very organized. And then for is clickable, what I'm going to make is the cursor pointer. What it does is basically it changed my cursor into a hand. It's very tiny here, but you can notice this is because this is clickable, right? And then for this draggable is going to be cursor grab. When you grab things, you can see I have the hand open because I can drag it, but it's very annoying that I can drag also the text. This is not what I want to do when I drag stuff. So what I'm going to do is just write this user select and none. Then this draggable don't select the text, and this is a nice experience. That's how you use template in Storybook. In our next lesson, we are going to see the concept of template list in Storybook. See you in the next one.